This video will show you how to migrate your vacuum sense configuration from the old GcodeDriver vacuum system to the new actuator-based system. First, we create a new actuator on the head that has the nozzle that you want to work with. Click on the actuators and click the plus and choose reference actuator. Select the actuator you just created and give it a name. I'm using H1 Vac, which stands for Head 1 Vacuum, and apply. Now we need to configure the actuator in GcodeDriver. We're going to use the same basic settings that we had for our vacuum settings previously. So choose the vacuum request command and copy its value. And then select the actuator and use the actuator read command, which is the equivalent, and paste the value in. Go back to the vacuum report regex and copy that. And once again, select the actuator and choose the actuator read regex and paste in the value. Due to a difference in how actuators work from the vacuum system, we have to change the regex variable name from vacuum to value. Now we can test the actuator that we've created. We go to the actuators tab and click the actuator, and we can click the read button to read from the actuator. And we can see what's happening if we look at the log. When we click read, we see that the vacuum command was sent. We received a response of vacuum colon 300, and then that was the response that came back for the actuator. So now we configure the nozzle to use the new actuator. Back in machine setup, we select our nozzle. At the bottom, there's the vacuum sense actuator name. We fill in the name that we gave the actuator, H1 Vac, and apply that. And on the nozzle tip, we'll set a default value for the vacuum on to 100 so that we can test. Since our actuator in this test case responds with 300, 100 is less than that, so it should be a valid test. We'll attempt to pick apart. And we can see in the log that we made a vacuum request at the end of the pick. So if we go back to the nozzle tip, and we'll set a value of 400, which is higher than the 300 that our actuator is returning, and attempt to pick again. And this time we get a pick failure, saying that the vacuum level of 300 is lower than the expected value of 400. And this shows that the vacuum system is working correctly. And that's all you need to do to migrate your vacuum configuration to the new system.